just lift up our voices to the Lord and worship Him and invite His presence in this place. He alone is God, He alone is worthy of our praise. The Bible says we enter this place. There is presence to dance, you enter His courts with praise. It's an absolute privilege for us to be in the presence of the Father this morning. Can we just raise our voice and say, Father, we thank you for the grace to be in your presence. Shall we pray together? Ancient of days, there is none like you. We celebrate you for the grace that is asked to be here this morning. We confess that you are God, besides whom there is none other. We confess that you will not deserve our worship. We thank you for the grace and the privilege to be here. We thank you, O God, that we can come into your presence this morning with song, with singing, with dancing, with celebration. We thank you that we can come before the one who is King, before the one who is Lord. We confess that there is none like you, and there is none to be compared to you. We confess that you alone deserve our praise, our worship, our exaltation, our adoration. As your children gather in this place, we have come to celebrate you, because you alone are God. There is none like you. Father, we worship you. We celebrate you. David says, this is the day that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Let's just thank the Lord again for an ultimate privilege that is asked to come into His presence and worship. His King, His Lord, the God who was highly exalted, brought Himself down and brought Himself to our level and made it possible for us to be able to worship Him. Can we just thank Him again? Father, it's a privilege for us to come to your presence and worship you. You who was God, exalted above all else. What is man that you were mindful of Him? Yet man that you think of Him. Yet you made Him little lower than the angels, and you crowned Him with glory and honor. Father, we celebrate you that exalted as you are, you have given the privilege to us made humans to be able to worship you. And so we just want to come in this morning and worship, in praise, and exaltation, confessing that you are God, beside whom there is none other. We celebrate you for the privilege to be yours to you. We celebrate you for the privilege to be yours. And so we worship you, we exalt you, we magnify you, we thank you for love manifested in that you have made us sons and daughters of the Most High God. We thank you for love manifested in that we can come into the presence of the one who is King and the one who is Lord. We thank you for love manifested in that we can come before you and worship. To you be all the glory and all the honor. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Good morning, saints. I don't know if you have already greeted each other, but I just wanted to welcome someone and wish them a warm welcome and ask you how was your week. And give them a word of encouragement until we're going to have a time of celebration. We want to recognize the presence of Pastor Joe and Dr. Chan. It's always a blessing to have you on. Can we just welcome them together just to say we appreciate the fact that you're here and we know that you're going to bless us. Amen. Just welcome someone this morning and just tell them God bless you. I'm happy to see you. I'm happy to see you. Lulu, it's a privilege to have you this morning. And we're just going to get into the presence of the Lord.
God bless you.
Amen. Psalm 103, if you have your Bible, just stand with me, and then we're going to sing that song that says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name." Psalm 103 from verse 1 to 5. If you get it, just say amen. I want us to sing this song as an act of worship. This morning, and as we're preparing for this service, one of the things that played very strongly in my heart is a sense of privilege that we have to worship God. The sense of privilege that we have to belong. The sense of privilege that we are beneficiaries of the work of the cross. This morning, as I was preparing for the service, I went back to this song that talked about the old rugged cross. That speaks of the blood, that speaks of forgiveness. It's such a wonderful mystery that by a single act of sacrifice on the cross, God changed our status. Yeah. And David crowns it in the psalm when he says, "Forget not all his benefits." He says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits." And I'm like, wow. So there are benefits to belonging. And he goes on to say, "Who forgives all your iniquities and heals all your diseases? Who redeems your soul from destruction? Who crowns you with loving kindness and tendernesses? Who satisfies your mouth with good things so that your youth is renewed as an eagle?" Amen. There's a passage that says that day that wait upon the Lord, it shall renew your strength. It shall soar on wings like eagles. It shall run and it shall not grow weary. The Lord Jesus Christ, when Moses was describing the experience of the children of Israel as they went to the desert, he says that your feet were not sore. As you went through the desert, there were desert conditions, but there was preservation. You went through the desert, but there was no evidence of the fact that you went through the desert. And that is the guarantee that we have as children of God. He says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits." The benefits of forgiveness of sin. David says this, "And blessed is the man whose iniquity the Lord does not hold against him." Now we will never be able to imagine, never be able to measure what is the weight of being and living guilt-free. Being able to come into the presence of the Lord and tell the Father, "Lord, I come before you, I just want to say I'm sorry, please forgive me." And going away from there with the assurance that whatever it is that we have confessed, he says that he's faithful and just to forgive us and to purify us from all unrighteousness. It's a benefit. They that are not in the Lord do not have that benefit. And that's one of the powerful things about the God that we serve. Because every other religion almost doesn't have that element of God can forgive you of your sin and cleanse your past and make you be born anew and have an ability to move forward. It's a benefit. I want to also stand and sing this song that says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul." And as you sing it this morning, I want you to be grateful and to sing it with an attitude of thanksgiving. We're going to sing the Benjamin Dube version that says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul." It's not the other version. It's a very common version. Most of you know this one. It comes from back in the day.
All right.
Okay.
Thank you.
songwriter says he woke you up this morning. Jeremiah says that if it's not of the grace of the Lord, you will not have made those mercies. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercy never comes to an end. They are new every morning. In the book of Lamentations, it says, great is thy faithfulness. The Lord has been good to you. He has given you the grace to go through one full week. He has probably seen you through circumstances and situations. I just want to open your mouth this morning as a first act of worship to say, Father, I thank you for your goodness to me. Thank you for preserving my family.